Hi there. Last week, Tesla presented their Cybertruck, and in this video, I want to tell you why the Cybertruck looks like it looks and how the Cybertruck is constructed based on the information available right now. What I have learned so far is that the Cybertruck is a form follows function approach. The decision to use a triangle form comes not from a standpoint of shocking the world by doing something completely different to stand out, but more of having a form that works best with the idea of cost-effective manufacturing. The monocoque, or exoskeleton as Tesla calls it, of the Cybertruck is 3 mm thick, cold-rolled stainless steel folded together, like an origami figure. In the end, this saves expensive stamping machines, where sometimes a part needs to be stamped several times in a row in different stamping machines to achieve the form the engineers wanted. Stamping machines are among the largest and most expensive components of a car factory. Also, less welding is used, and the overall construction uses less parts than a traditional unibody design. I assume the Cybertruck won't be a pure monocoque design, as information on this topic is still unclear, but I think there will be unibody design elements inside, especially considering crash structures. So probably the Cybertruck will be a combination of monocoque and unibody structures combined in the most effective way, especially folded wherever possible. But using folding techniques has a trade-off. The flat panels tend to bend or twist. So to counter that, you can either make the folding material thicker or stronger. For example, you could use cold-rolled stainless steel with 5 mm or thicker, or use a more expensive material like carbon fiber. But these solutions make the car either heavier or more expensive. Now comes the trick Tesla used. You optimize the folding form of the monocoque to achieve the needed stiffness while using the 3 mm thick cold-rolled stainless steel. The starting point is a design like a truss bridge, in its simplest load-spreading shape, a triangle set on its hypotenuse. And combining this design starting point with angular shapes all over, almost like a Lockheed F-117 attack aircraft. Via Twitter, Elon Musk also said that even if they wanted to stamp the cold-rolled stainless steel, they could not stamp it, because it is too hard for the stamping machines. Therefore, by using this very hard cold-rolled stainless steel, you could almost say that Tesla is forced to use these angular shapes. Though this is the reason the Cybertruck looks like it looks, and it's a prime example of form follows function. On top of that, with the decision to use stainless steel for the exoskeleton, there is no paint shop needed to coat and paint the exoskeleton to protect it from the elements. Stainless steel cannot rust, and by using this material, Tesla skips the production process of coating, painting, or even galvanizing, which all the other car manufacturers need to do with their unibody cars or body-on-frame trucks. Aside from not rusting, the cold-rolled stainless steel exoskeleton is way harder than traditional sheet metal parts on normal cars and trucks, as was demonstrated by Franz von Holzhausen in the presentation with a sledgehammer, and Tesla's claim that it can also withstand a 9 mm full metal jacket bullet. So you don't have to be worried about getting dents over the years by, for example, other drivers ramming their car doors against your Cybertruck or using the Cybertruck as a work truck day to day. Just for comparison, I want to let you know that cars today use a sheet strength of about 0.6 to 0.8 millimeters. In the end, the exoskeleton idea with usage of cold-rolled stainless steel in a triangle form saves money by reducing production complexity, which is probably the reason why Tesla can offer a full-size pickup truck accelerating almost as fast as a Ford F-150 Raptor and having air suspension as standard for $40,000. One word to the topic of crash safety. Right now, there's no information on how good the Cybertruck with the hard exoskeleton will perform in a crash test, but I think Tesla does not plan to massively damage its reputation as a car manufacturer building one of the safest cars on the planet. If Tesla cannot achieve top results with the hard exoskeleton architecture, the Cybertruck will surely aim at being at least the safest full-size pickup, because full-size pickup trucks are safe, but not on the level of, for example, a Tesla Model X or Volvo XC90. This comes mainly of the usage of the body-on-frame architecture on full-size pickup trucks right now. At last, I want to say that Elon Musk confirmed via Twitter that you can get the Cybertruck in some form of matte black, which will be a vinyl wrap instead of some layers of paint. And of course, you can buy your Cybertruck in the basic stainless steel variant and wrap it with any color you want by a tuning company or yourself, which will surely go faster and therefore cheaper than wrapping a traditional pickup because of the angular form. So that's it from me on the design and construction of the Cybertruck based on the information available right now. Please like, share, subscribe, and also hit the notification bell, as more videos are coming soon.